We do have some beautiful old carbon comps that I have purchased in bulk, like a couple of thousand. And we have a couple of special spots that we put them that we need to pre-fit before we get some of the other stuff going in. Sit down and out of the way. Take a twisted, beautiful wire. We'll get the cutting back a little bit. As you can see by all those videos, it takes a long time to do these builds. They're quite sophisticated, and I'm not getting some circuit board propagated in China. I'm very proud to say that I figured a good 90%, if not more, is all done with parts that are North American or European. I source everything to make sure. You can buy, let's say, a Cornell capacitor, and it could be made in Hungary, it could be made in Ukraine, it could be made in China. I source it all out to see, to make sure I'm getting the ones that I want. And I think the quality's better, to tell you the truth, and that's a lot to do with the reason. Not against global trade, obviously, but if things aren't consistent and things aren't made the same all the time, then I'm not going to purchase that product. Even for the F&T caps that I'm using, when I get a batch in, I will destroy one to make sure I'm not getting some knockoff. I can't afford to have that with some, you know, 250 volt cap sitting underneath in the thing. That's another of my quality control things. This particular amp has two completely separate channels with their own EQs.
Just working out of the back shop, so if you noticed,
this is another day. Same shirt though. I didn't get too dirty yesterday working on amps. It's not like being in construction, so I'm wearing the same shirt again. If you can't handle that, don't buy an amp off me. You don't want me to go on about soldering rant again, do you? How many times have I done that in these videos? Too many, you're saying, I know. Way too many. It's my pet peeve, I guess, since... Well, just look at the amp, how much... Oh, here I go again. How much has to do with soldering? The whole stinking thing. So if you're not really good at soldering, you're not building a great amp, so... All right. Hopefully that'll be the last rant about it. Actually is time to do some grounding. But that grounding, because it's so crucial to my sound, I believe, it's going to be on speed. Here we go for a speed dial. Okay, I guess we can go back to touch more conversation ranting. If you build a printed circuit board amp, don't even bother watching my videos because you won't agree with the differences that I hear. And if you run DC voltage on your heaters, don't bother either, because you won't believe anything I say, because you don't hear the difference in that either. You just won't believe that I do. Means nothing to me. Just saying. Some people think I'm arrogant. I'm not. Telling you my experiences doesn't make any difference to me whether you believe me or not. Those that do believe me are the ones that play my amps to hear the difference. And the biggest compliment I've ever had from producers and from players is that when they get my amp, it sounds like it's 30 years old right out of the box. And that's what I've been striving for from the very beginning, to make it sound as rich and beautiful as my old 55 Bassman, original Bassman, to have all of that character, knowing that it's breathing properly. And that's what I pushed for on my amps. So I've just shared some of my experiences. I haven't tried to be arrogant, but trying to be a know-it-all. I don't know everything, but I do know what I hear, and I know what makes a difference. There's actually a fellow up here that worked for Bombardier, and he can machine and make anything he wants. He actually left school, I guess, in grade 9 and was mentored by a physics major. He's borderline genius, and he challenged me when he was over here one time, and we used to have big talks together. Challenged me to figure out why I would do something like on an old video I had with Paul Onetta, who was with Big Wreck at the time, and all I did is move a ground from one pot, one volume control, from one spot to an inch and a half over. And Paulo said, man, it's like you change resistors and caps. It's like he was astonished. And I, at the time, couldn't totally explain why it made such a difference. Now I know, because this guy just kept saying, that's bollocks. You don't know? I said, well, we used to think that the universe was collapsing in on itself and eventually just going to become a vacuum again or something. And now we know that it's expanding at a rate that, can't even keep up with it. The Hubble's out there and it just keeps going and going. And it's been expanding from the beginning. And I said, I think it's just one of those things where I know it affects it. I can't quite explain it. And he wouldn't let me stop till I figured it all out. And I did. I know why that ground now, but I'm not going to say why. I'm just saying, even if you look at my amp and you look at it, you might wonder, unless you go really deep into the tech of it, you're going to wonder why the grounding is different, but it is.